120 million Kenya shillings for the American market only. Kenya Tourism Board is going to invest. This is to boost the activation of promotion of the destination in the market. So this is key. Before it was less, now it is more. As well as the Kenya Civil Aviation Amendment Act, that is very critical to open up the skies for American airlines to come into the country. But our total budget that we have given for development for Kenya Tourism Board was 1.5 billion. And this market alone has taken $1.2 million, which is 120 million shillings. Attendance of all these international conferences that have come in from WTO to UNCTAD to TICAD has confirmed Kenya is safe. So this is the advantage we are taking to open up ourselves to the American market. But there are two things which are key to the American market. One is accessibility by airlines, which we as the government have confirmed the passage of the bill, the amendment bill of the Civil Aviation Act, so that we can be able to conform with the rules of FIA. Yeah? The second thing is that we are now in the construction process of the cruise ship facility in Mombasa, and the American market is big in cruise ships. So that's another product that we are going to launch during ASTA, as well as our trip in the USA in December. So these are key things that we are doing for this market so that it can be able to be a number one market for Kenya. Well, this is another conference tourism. We are promoting Kenya to the United States, but this time to the travel agents who sell the destination Africa and also Kenya. So this we are going to expose Kenya to the American Society of Travel Agents. And they always have their annual destination meetings. So this time they're going to hold it for the second time in Africa. And it happens that we have won the bid, which is Kenya in 2017. So we're expecting about 2,000 travel agents who sell outbound, and this will promote Kenya in the United States. Already, USA market is a very good, resilient market. Our best figures were 125,000 arrivals in 2012. This time, because of the challenges we had, it's 85,000 in 2015. I believe, and the investment the Kenya Tourism Board is going to put of almost 120 million Kenya shillings in that market, we believe it will boost it and be able to increase the numbers from the USA.
The choice for Kenya by the ASTA members global, who are over 5,000, is really an endorsement to this destination. Number one, it positions Kenya and reassures the world that we are able to hold international conferences, like we have seen recently that Kenya has been holding all these conferences. So we continue with that positive visibility and impetus as a country to be able to welcome guests here and give them flawless conference facilities. The other thing, of course, it is that the conference brings in business to Kenya. These are paying guests. They will fill our hotels, our taxis, our tour operators, our airlines. They will be booming with business.
Because the numbers and the demographics which have been given by Madam Secretary here show very well that the numbers in US are 8 times more than what UK has in terms of potential. The question now is, how come we've never attained that? Now, that is where ASTA comes in. The biggest association in the world, 152 billion US travel market, 80% controlled by ASTA. So simply by getting 7% of that, we'll have reached our 5-year target. The thing is, we need to start from where ASTA is outside Kenya. We've for a long time neglected this US market. We should have actually plugged into the US market earlier than this. And that's the reason Waziri mentioned very well. He said, we've got an integral plan to make the US market our number one market. For the first quarter, which the KTB of the KTB MD, acting MD, mentioned, America is doing well. The first quarter, it shows very well that the numbers were adding up. The US, which has 7 times more potential tourists compared to UK, has been giving us the second category of numbers coming to this country. Now,